Hey dolls, welcome back to my channel. My name's CHIOMA and this is Heart Talks. If you guys are new here, welcome to the club, welcome to the channel, welcome to the family. We're glad to have you here. So today I did a little digging in my analytics of my channel and I was trying to understand like the demographics of the people who actually watch my videos, and I wanted to deliver something extra special to you guys. So after a little bit of research, I realized that a lot of the people who are watching are from the age of 18 to about 28, and that's great because I fall right into that demographic. So I wanted to speak directly to you guys, and something that I felt like I needed to hear at 18 and into early adulthood is this: learning how to choose good friends. I know it sounds like so elementary and something that we usually don't really pay a lot of mind to. Typically, we just befriend whoever happens to fall into our paths and lives, whether it's from work, school, church, whatever. But it's so important to understand and recognize who you attach yourself to. We're not even talking about relationships, we're talking about friendships. Those are so critical. Here are my, like, I'm gonna say five things that I would really, really urge you to look deeply into when picking friends and why it's so important. So here's the why. First, very important to pick good friends because who you attach yourself to aids you in how you go along pursuing your goals and your dreams. You, one, want to surround yourself with people who are like-minded, someone who is able to see you aside from the circumstances, aside from the things that the world might classify you and put you in a box, and allows you to grow in the process of who you are becoming. A lot of people get very attached to somebody's identity in the environment in which they met them in. For example, if you met someone in high school and you try to bring them along your life into college, a lot of those relationships dissipate. I mean, how many friends do we truly have from high school who we can call real true friends? Because they are not able to flex and mold as we grow and shape. And so a lot of those friends kick rocks. Like, they don't even sustain you into your adulthood. So you wanna find somebody who's willing to grow with you and adjust and mold with you as you do in your personal journey. Second, very important to find someone who is not sucking the life out of you. Now, soul sucking friends, people who see your beautiful aura, your positivity, and they gravitate towards it. They will, trust me, they will. They love it, they see it, and they want it, but they do not feed it. They just take it until you're drained. So you want to find that perfect balance between, okay, there's this fly in here and I'm literally going to lose my mind here. Hello, get the f out of here. So someone who not only you can pour into, but they are pouring into you. It has to be a symbiotic relationship. It's not selfish to want someone to give you energy because you know that you are giving them positive energy in return. You feel me? You feel me? So that's number two. Number three, someone who, now this is a little personal, but in my opinion, very important, especially if you are a family of Heart Talks, you understand the vision and the purpose behind the channel, someone who loves God. That really should be number one, but I didn't want to scare a lot of you guys away with that one. Just kidding. So someone who loves God. When you are in a friendship with someone who also understands what being a follower of God is and what living out a God-purposed life looks like, they will push you and hold you accountable whenever you are out of alignment. I call those wonderful, wonderful people my soul sisters. Why? Because when I am veering off track and I'm no longer in alignment with where God has me, and I'm trying to reach out of my season and rush the season that I'm in because I'm so eager to get to the next destination, they bring me back to earth, honey. They let me know, look, sis, bask in the wonderful glory of where you're at currently. It's great. It's beautiful. Don't rush the process. We need God-visioned minded people to remind us that the season that we're in right now is purposed, beautiful, lovely, and we're going to miss it. I'm just saying, you're literally going to miss this time that you're in right now. You're going to be in the next season that you're so eager to get to, and you're going to be like, dang, I low-key miss when I was chilling up in a crib in my pajamas all day. Like, I really wish I could. You're going to miss it. So enjoy it while you got it. You know what I'm saying? So that's number three. Number four. Right? Are we on number four? So I don't really know the word to describe this quality or characteristic of a human being, but I will just say, as a friend and as the receiving end of a friendship, it is important to know how to remind somebody of who they are in the middle of a shit show, right? In the middle of disaster, when they have lost the sense of self and have really, really gone down the rabbit hole of self-deprecating thoughts and doubt and fear and all of those things, someone who's going to remind you of you and lift you up mentally. Mental health is so important, and someone who can speak to that and understand where you're at in your journey does not define you is extremely, extremely pivotal. Someone who respects your time, space, and energy. Although I can appear to be extremely extroverted, and even at one point, I believe that I was an extrovert, and when I reassessed myself today, it is unbeknownst to me that I am really not as extroverted as I thought. I really do admire my alone time. So someone who respects your time and space and allows you to engage or not engage as you feel fit. Sometimes people that you let into your inner circle have this sense of, entitlement. They feel like they're entitled to your time and your wisdom and your energy. And no, you're not. It's okay to say no. And it's important to have friends who respect that. I think that that is something that of my girlfriends, who I really call my close friends, they all know. We all know that about each other. We all respect each other's growth, our space, our pace, and our vision and purpose and our passions. And we speak to those things and encourage each other in this journey together. So all that to say, it's not always vital to have many friends. As we all know, having a few, one or two, if it's one, that's great. But just a few good friends to help you along this journey will really, really make this life so much more enjoyable, so much more memorable, and so much more manageable. Because sometimes, let's face it, life sucks. Like, it does. So with good friends, I think that we can really, really cultivate the womanhood, sisterhood, and lifestyle that we so desire. We can pour into people, receive what people have to give us, and give them back the best versions of ourselves in every way. And yeah, that's all I got for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for joining. If you have any comments, questions, desires, prayer requests, let me know in the comment sections below. We will be back next week with much more content. Thank you for joining. Peace and love, friends.